Hey guys, Jannik here for CineCom.net and welcome back to Copycat Friday. And do you know what time it is? It's time for another Billie Eilish tutorial.
And today we will be falling through the sky just like she did in the music video All the Good Girls Go to Hell. However, I do have to say that we kept it quite simple and short today. And why, you ask? Well, that's because we are working on a huge project and collaboration with Adobe. But you will see more on that next week when we will be posting it on Tuesday. So definitely check that out. Okay, Lorenzo, let's start.
And the first thing we need is a green screen shot. And we are in luck because for our Adobe shoot, we already created a green screen, as you can see right here. Of course, yours doesn't need to be this big. You can also use something like this. There we go. Next, place your actor in front of the green screen. And now, we need to fake the movement of falling from a great height. So you can let your actor lay on a stool or let him hang with some climbing gear. Then once he is in place, your actor can act his role and we are going to create some wind with a leaf blower. And that's it. Except for the clouds. These you can film yourself or you can make it yourself really easy and go to Storyblocks Video. With their huge stock video library, you will definitely find some perfect clouds for your project. We even found a cloud with an alpha layer, which makes our work so much easier in post-production. Besides having beautiful cloud videos, they also have an awesome new feature, which is called Maker. With this video creator tool, you can easily customize stock videos with title animations, transitions, and so on. You can even use the provided templates to make your own new video creations. So let's recap. You get a video creator tool and a huge stock library for only one single price per year. So don't waste any time and start downloading right away with the first link in the description down below.
Okay guys, now that we have our footage, we can start with creating our effect. And we are going to create this by using the 3D tools and space from After Effects. First thing we need to do is create a composition. Now for this effect, I'm making the composition 1080p, because that way we can easily scale our 4K cloud clips without losing quality. Next, place a green screen shot in the composition and key out a green. Now let's start with creating the 3D space. And for this we need a camera. So go up to the menu on top, select layer, new, and choose camera. Now choose the settings that you want. We are going for the typical 35mm and press OK. Then you can make your green screen shot 3D by enabling this box right here. Position it where you want in your composition and then it's time for the background clouds. First we are creating a solid layer and adding a ramp effect to it. Set both colors to a gray tint and place the lightest gray on top. Of course, set the solid layer 3D and then we are going to place it in our 3D space. For this we are going to switch to the two view layout. One view will show us the active camera and the other one will show us the left or the right side, giving us the possibility to move the layers better on the Z and the Y space. In other words, move the layers towards and away from the camera, but also up and down. So with this in mind, let's move the solid layer on the Z axis away from the camera. However, this means that we also need to scale the solid layer as it will become smaller on our active camera view. So scale that solid clip a lot, like a whole lot, especially downwards as we are going to move down with our camera and we want the solid clip to remain in our shot. Okay, now that we have our background, we can add the clouds in the exact same way. Take a cloud shot and make it 3D. Move it back on the Z axis, but not behind the gray solid layer. Of course, scale it a bunch. Next, you can also add a feathered mask to the cloud layer to remove any clip edges you will see. Now repeat this a couple of times until you completely cover the gray solid layer with clouds. Okay, the background is done. Now we can add some smaller clouds that will create the depth of the scene. These will come in front and behind the actor, giving the feeling that he is really falling through the clouds. Now again, you can use stock clips for this. Just take a cloud clip and mask out the cloud that you want, set the blending mode to screen and position it in the 3D space. However, play around with positioning, maybe place it in front of your actor or just behind him. Really make the position of the clouds random when you are adding more and more clouds. Of course, also move the clouds downwards and to the side, creating a long and wide 3D scene downwards. Oh yeah, also add different clouds. Don't just use one and keep copying it. Use multiple clips or be creative and make your own cloud with the fractal noise. I'll leave a link in the description below with a cool tutorial for cloud making. And poof, we have our 3D cloud scene. Now the only thing we have to do is our camera movement downwards. The first thing we need to do is parent the actor clip to the camera with the pick whip tool. Then for the camera, enable the animation for the point of interest and the position. Go a couple of seconds further in time and move the camera all the way down, creating a downwards movement. Then the last thing you need to do is set the depth of field on, place your focus distance on the actor and increase the aperture. Oh yeah, two more details. Enable the motion blur for everything and maybe add a wiggle expression to the camera position to give a more natural movement. Time for Genix Fun Fact Fountain! Do you guys know After Effects Beta? Well, this is the newest version of After Effects, which is still in its testing phase. But everybody with an Adobe subscription can use it and test it out. And let me tell you, this new version will be so awesome. We already mentioned in a previous video that they will have a super strong rotoscope option, but they will also have new and improved 3D tools, making your 3D editing a lot easier. So definitely check that out. And that was it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Storyblocks Video for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Hey Jordy, what are you doing?
I'm making fire. A dragon breeding fire.
Make it breed fire, Jordy!
Wait, hang on. Rah, 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 rah.